Alright, back to part 2, descending now. You can see 13,100 feet going down to our final approach fixed altitude of 3,800 feet. And, yeah. Checking, yep. Our approach should be around there somewhere. I need to desperately get a OpenLC North America. I bought North America when it was only Canada and Alaska, thinking it's going to be a free upgrade, pretty much an update for all of North America. But I guess not. I don't know. I never got anything, so I think I have to buy OpenLC North America again just to be able to have the United States included. But, oh well. Yeah, if you guys know how to upgrade, if there is an upgrade option, let me know.
Hello, flight deck.
Hi, it's Andy at L1. How can I help you?
Let's see, are we going to arrive early or late or on time or what's going on here? 19:30. We're arriving late.
Hi, just to let you know, we're going to be arriving a bit late.
Thanks for the update.
19:30, same time of arrival. Flight time was supposed to be 5 hours and 37 minutes, so flight time is about right. I don't know. Runway 26 left, we're gonna hope and get Alpha 5 for exit. We'll see. Around 10,000 feet, go and set this to ADF. We'll tune in our ILS. Set our approach here. Into the approach checklist. Approach checklist.
Checked. Altimeters.
2-9-er, 8-7 set.
2-9-8-7 set. Approach checklist complete.
Alright, and we are ready for... We're pretty much ready to land.
10,000.
Absolutely beautiful seeing the mountainous terrain in the horizon here. Looks quite good in my opinion. Obviously the textures are a little bit, I mean they're default prepared so they don't look very good. That's why I want to get Orbex North America, but I won't be able to get that anytime soon. So I have to wait, but no problem really. Now we're gonna go ahead and arm our localizer. For now the FPS is really good, but as soon as the airport loads in I'm sure it's gonna die down to the negative frames.
Localizer alive.
Airport's around there somewhere.
Slope alive.
Yep, now you can see the frames are starting to die now. You can see the airport. Let's see whatever my frame's at, 20 to 25. That's how fast it can go. yeah. Flaps 1.
Speed checked. Thanks. Captain, the cabin is secure.
Flaps 5.
Speed checked. Flaps
5. Frames now. Yeah, that's another heavy scenery, unfortunately. Flaps 10.
Speed checked. Flaps 10.
Gear down.
Gear down.
Flaps 15.
Speed checked. Flaps 15. Radio altimeter alive. Cabin crew, take your seats.
Flaps 30.
Final approach fix. Height checked. Missed approach altitude set. Speed checked.
Landing checklist.
Flaps 30. Landing checklist. Engine start switches.
Continuous.
Speed brake. Double check that, please. Landing gear.
Down.
Flaps.
30 green light.
Landing checklist complete.
Cleared.
Check.
Cycle the flight directors.
Recycling flight directors.
Approaching minimums. 100. Minimums.
Ground visible.
Landing.
Check.
30. 20. 10.
Speed brake up. Cursor's low.
We didn't make Alpha 5, but we sure will make Alpha
break,
6.
Check.
Landing rate was 127.
3 minutes.
Shut down right engine.
Engine start lever number 2, confirm.
Confirmed. Confirmed.
Cut off.
Jesus, what are my frames? Oh my god. Fly Tampa. Work on optimization, for goodness sake. Seriously, it's horrible. The NGX isn't even very bad on frames, and can't imagine what the F-Labs will be like here. Lights and doors.
Check. Cabin crew, disarm doors and cross-check. Doors disarmed, APU on the bus.
Shutdown checklist.
Shutdown checklist. Fuel pumps, off. ROV, off. Hydraulic panel, set. Flaps.
Up, no light.
Okay,
up.
Baggage handling is complete and the
set.
Aircraft is clear.
Engine start levers.
Cut off.
Weather radar.
Off.
Off. Shutdown checklist complete.
Alright guys, that is the end of this flight service from Boston to Vegas. I can now confirm both these airports are the two most demanding airports you'll probably be able to buy, including London. So be careful with your system. And I have a GTX 1070, which is not a terrible card. It's obviously, as you can see in all my videos, I get pretty decent FPS in pretty much every airport, even with ultimate traffic. Here I don't have ultimate traffic enabled, and I get less than 20 frames. So be careful with these two sceneries. Fly Tampa somehow is not like optimization. I'll also have to check the settings for the airport to see what I can change there. I had the PVR option set. I think I'm going to change that off now. Turn that off. So you can see buildings in the background have PVR, and I think the buildings here in the airport as well. But I think I'm going to turn it into static, because that definitely will help with performance. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and we'll see you in the next video. Until then.